Ivanka Trump cut out of her father's Asia trip early to come back and make the case for the Republican Party's tax reform plan. She sat down with us yesterday out in Simi Valley, California at the Reagan Library to tell us about that as well as to talk about the plight of American women compared to that of men. Here's part of our conversation. Watch. You cut the Asia trip short, you're part of it, to come back to carry the banner for this bill. Why?
Yes, I was in Japan at the invitation of Prime Minister Abe to speak about women's participation in the workforce, which is a critical issue to the growth of the Japanese economy, but also something we're very focused on in our administration as well. But I decided not to go on because ultimately tax reform is central to the administration's plans over the coming months. And it's critically important that we get it done, and we believe we can get it done. So I decided not to meet up and continue the trip with the president.
So if I ran into you in an elevator and we had like two floors for you to make your pitch for the tax plan, what would it be?
Well, there's a dual focus, and that's providing much-needed tax relief to middle-income families and cutting taxes generally so that our businesses can be competitive and thrive in a modern economy and in a global world where there's tremendous competition. And our tax plan accomplishes both of those things.
It's a pretty good pitch.
Oh, well, thank you.
So you said that
and simplification. We like simplification. So
You were speaking to the Japanese about the need for further workforce participation for women, and that's consistent with the theme that you've been on top of since the beginning of the administration. I've got three daughters and a son, so I'm paying attention to the numbers on this, and it seems like in this country anyway, the crisis is among boys, not girls. Girls graduate from college in much higher numbers. They die from drug ODs at much lower rates, same with suicide. Mm-hmm. The majority of managers are women. It really seems like the problem is not women in the United States. And I wonder if you think that's a wrong analysis or...
I do. I think there are... certainly the problems you noted are broader than economic problems.
Yes.
So those may be individual to boys. But while women comprise 47% of the workforce, we are very underrepresented in fields that will be critically important when you think about the jobs of the future. So you look at the technology industry, we represent 21% of people in tech. That's a problem when you think about where jobs will be created going forward. We're 13% of engineers, so we have to change that. And I think that our tax plan takes a big step in terms of helping the American family with the high cost of raising children. The fact that the average American family spends almost 30% of pre-tax income on the cost of childcare. So the cost of childcare has gone through the roof, and families just can't afford it. So women are disproportionately leaving the workforce. So there are unique challenges, but I think our tax plan is very helpful towards providing middle-income relief so that families can thrive. An expansion of the child tax credit, maintaining
right.
the child and dependent care credit as part of tax reform, doubling the standard deduction. So really, it's the central theme is middle-income Americans and supporting them. We spend less than any country in the developed world on children between the ages of 0 and 5. It's just a fact. We don't invest enough resources.
Meaning the government spends less?
Meaning as a society, yes, early childhood education. We as families
spend a lot.
But as a government in terms of, schooling starts at the age of 5.
Right.
There's not a lot of support for families in those early years. Indeniably, it's very expensive to raise children. That's if you're a stay-at-home parent who's investing in potentially after-school activities, mommy
right.
and me classes, food, and whatever it is that they think is the best investment to help their family and their children.
Last question. Are you worried that the Senate will change it in ways that make it less effective or even unacceptable?
I'm optimistic that the Senate takes what's been created and actually enhances it. And, I think that's a great opportunity.
Thanks very much, Ivanka Trump.
Thank you.